What's up, guys and gals? Today we're going to teach you how to disassemble, clean, and then put back together an Abu Garcia 6500 C3 reel. Now this is a 2014 model, and I've put the power handle on there. Other than that, there's no difference. I've made no upgrades. So everything I show you here will be basically a stock Abu Garcia 6500 C3. I have a few other models behind me here, Blue Cat Specials and some older models, and I've got about 12 of them. My local shop here charges me, you know, somewhere around $20, $25 per reel to have it cleaned, greased, and serviced. So by doing this, you know, I'm saving myself a couple hundred dollars each year. And you'll also be able to do the same after watching this video. So sit back, enjoy a cigar, and let's take apart some reels. Here's the tools we're gonna use to clean our Abu Garcia reel. Obviously you're gonna need your 6500 C3. We're gonna need a wrench to tighten and loosen a nut that's underneath this nut cap here. We're gonna need a number one or number two size flathead and Phillips screwdrivers, as well as a flathead and Phillips precision screwdrivers. The precision screwdrivers are more for working the screws in and out, and the number one or number twos are for tightening them down really well or loosening them. Also, we're gonna use this flathead for picking at a little C-clamp we got in there. So those definitely come in handy. We're gonna use Q-tips to clean and apply grease. This tub of grease cost me $5, and as you can see, it's gonna last a lifetime. We only use a little dab at a time, so that stuff definitely lasts. You can use any kind of reel oil. This is just the one I use. Most times when you buy a reel, they give you a little tube in the box. That's fine. I just use this. Have a rag handy because we're gonna clean out these face plates. And at one point there's some washers that we need to dry very well, and we need to make sure our hands are dry too. So make sure you have a rag or two handy, some paper towels, and those should be all the tools that we need to get this clean. All right, let's get into this. First thing we're gonna do is pop off this face plate. There's three Phillips screws. I suggest once you take anything off of this reel, you set it down in a safe place in the same order that you took it off. That way when you go back to put it together, you can just kind of follow the pieces, and that way you'll make sure you won't have anything left over. So again, you just pop those three screws off. Now, before removing this, I suggest flipping it over because there's going to be two black spacers and a spring plate that'll come off, and possibly the spool. The spool, you know, just disconnects like that. We're going to set that aside. Inside here you can see the spring plate, and then these are the two black spacers. So we'll just go ahead and set that aside. Now, I've already kind of been through this reel and cleaned it. That's why you'll see the grease on there. But what you would want to do, we'll just go ahead and service this side because there's not a lot to it. You know, take your Q-tips or whatever, clean off the grease, clean off any dirt that might be in there. You know, you don't have to use grease remover or anything. Just a rag or some Kleenexes, paper towel, whatever. And then what we're gonna do here is we're gonna apply some new grease. So get your grease, get your Q-tip. You know, all you need is just a little dab. And you're gonna just kind of put some around those spokes there, and then some around these outer spokes as well. You know, I just kind of move it along put a little on there. It doesn't have to be a lot, because once these pieces start moving around each other, they'll get greased up. So there you go. That's pretty much it for that piece there. We'll just set it aside. Now on this piece that came off of there, there's really nothing to do. If you want, wipe it down, that's fine. There might be a little bit of gunk on there, but it probably won't be too dirty. But just go ahead and wipe that clean. No oil or grease needed here. Okay, next we're gonna take the spool housing here off from this plate so we can start servicing the worm gear here in the guide. So on this side, we've got three thumb screws. They actually will not come completely out of this faceplate here. So basically you just have to loosen them up until it pulls apart. The screws that hold this piece together are these two Phillips head screws there. So like I said, just loosen up these three thumb screws until it's loose enough to pull apart. See, that'll just separate from there. Oops, one of them's still stuck. There we go. We're gonna go ahead and set this piece aside, because that's probably the most involved piece that we'll use. So we'll just set that aside. Now we're gonna concentrate on this. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna remove the worm gear and the guide. Now, inside here, this is actually a cap. There's a spot for a screwdriver right there. There is something called a pawl in there, what moves along this worm gear and moves it. It helps it slide. So when we take this apart, be careful, because that little piece might fall out. So to start, this has just got a clip on it that just slides on and off like that. Slide it off. Pull it off, use your towel or whatever just to wipe that clean and dry. We won't grease this or oil or anything like that, so just set that aside. Okay, now your worm gear actually will be able to pull right out, but like I said, this pawl is gonna stop this from all coming out. So first we need to loosen that. And I'd say even take it off if you want. Just be careful. There's the cap. You can see the pawl is this little silver thing in there. That's all it is. Small piece, a very important piece, so be very careful. Okay, now your worm gear is just gonna come right out of there. So will the guide. The guide, you won't need to do anything to it, so wipe it down. Maybe run a Q-tip through the hole there. No oil, no grease here. Okay, now that you have your housing left, same thing. You don't need to do anything to it. Just shine it up, make it look pretty. I'm going to go ahead and set that aside. Now, your worm gear here is just going to pull apart. Okay. Now, the casing for it, I like to just run a toothpick or a Q-tip down in there, get rid of some of that gunk and grease. careful, there's a little end piece here that can come out, so just be careful with that. Same with the worm gear itself. You know, I just run a Q-tip over the grooves there. Get all the grime out of there. Clean it up as best you can. Okay, we're actually going to go ahead and assemble everything we've taken apart so far. So we're going to start with the worm gear. This can only go in one way. See, this is a rounded end. This end kind of, it has that stopper in it plus a groove. So it can only go in this way. Now, what we're going to do here, we're going to place a drop of oil on top, just one drop there, and then also one drop on the white plastic piece. I just like to rotate it a little bit, kind of work it around. That's all you got to do. So right now, to put the worm gear back together, these should be the pieces that we have. The worm gear, the guide, the paw cap, and this little clip. Now, this part takes a little bit of patience because what you have to do is put your guide through the worm gear at the same time you're trying to get it up in that track up there. Oh, I guess I should mention here, it is a good idea to run a Q-tip or, you know, something up in that track, get that kind of cleaned out. So, as best you can, you're going to hold this, you know, with one hand and kind of everything else with the other hand. When you put your worm gear into this piece, there's a round hole and a hole where you can see there's, you know, a design that fits perfectly with that end. So obviously you want to stick it in there. And you want to make sure your grooves are facing, you know, the real seat here. Just go ahead and slide the guide on there. Now what I try to do here is I try to put that top part in the guide, up at the top, and then I try to get the worm gear casing here to line up with that hole over there. There we go. Now I'm going to put pressure here on my right finger. And I'm going to turn this upside down. And I'm going to put this pawl in there. I just drop it in and kind of shift the guide. And then it should fall into place. And I'll put the cap on there. Maybe. Okay, I'll just finger tighten it for now. And then what I'll do is I'll put it back together. Like I said, this part can be a little tricky trying to keep the guide and the top groove and get this all together. There, we got it. And then I'll come back and tighten this down once I have everything in place. And I'd give it a good turn. Now you don't want that coming loose on you. Dry off your hands if you have any grease on them. Careful, because that will happen. It doesn't necessarily lock into place. That's the unfortunate problem. So if you keep bumping it, it'll pop back out. But Okay. Now, to keep that from popping out, we're going to go back and put this on there. So again, there's two little posts here. Sits on there like that, and then just slides over. There you go. You can spin that. You'll see your worm gears moving the guide. Now what we're going to do here is we're going to put a drop of oil up in the top groove there. And I like to put two drops of oil on each side and then spin it to work all that oil around. Now I do not use grease here because that attracts dirt and grime and that can clog up your worm gear. So again, I would suggest oil here and not grease. Okay, we'll go ahead and get our side plate here. We're also going to get our spring and our two black washers and our spacers, actually. So those are the pieces we should have. We're going to take our spring plate here and set it right on those two posts, just like that. Now these black spacers go on top of those posts, right here and right here. I'm going to take our plate, make sure your bait clicker is in the off position. We're going to line it up with those holes and put it on. Now it's going to feel a little squishy when you push down. That's all right, just push it down, get it into place, put those screws back in there. And there's three of those. Make sure they're nice and tight. Okay, there you go. Halfway home. Now for the spool, we'll just go ahead and get that clean and serviced. And wipe it down. That'll actually pop out real easy, just like that. And this white piece just pops right off. This part stays on, however. Again, here I'd recommend using your Q-tip, cloth, whatever. Get all the gunk off it. That piece fell out. Just put it back in there. Usually I don't have that problem, but what we're going to do here is we're going to drop a piece of oil right in the middle. We're going to pop this gear back on and make sure it snaps, otherwise it will fall off. On this end too, drop of oil. There you go, that's done. You can see where the grease is on here, because that's the piece that makes contact with those gears down there. It'll go in that way. Go ahead and clean this off. We'll set that aside for later when we put the whole thing back together. So now let's get into this. This is probably the most intensive part. We've already taken everything apart from this by loosening these thumb screws. Now we're going to get into it by undoing these screws, but first we're going to start with the handle. So we want to take off this nut cap here. Should have a Phillips screw there. Pop that off kind of carefully so your little screw doesn't go flying somewhere. Okay, now this is one of the most important parts about fixing these. There is a tiny little clamp on here. It's a C-clamp. Very spring-loaded. Will fly thousands of miles if you're not careful. So what I do is I stick, here's the open end and here's the closed end. I stick my precision flat screwdriver in there and I put my thumb up against it and I pull back. That usually does a pretty good job of getting that off. Go ahead and set that aside. We're going to use our wrench now to take this nut off. At least loosen it anyway. That's what holds your handle on. Pop that off. Your handle will come right off. Now there is a washer right here. Pay attention to how it's on. It should be kind of bowed in the middle. So be sure it goes back on that way. So just pay attention to how it's sitting. Take it off. Set it down. Now for your star drag, that should just spin right off. Now there's two washers in here. Again, pay attention to how they're sitting because they need to go back on in that particular order. They should also look like a pair of parentheses, like that. The bottom one should be bowed towards the bottom and the top one should be bowed towards the top. So just pay attention to how they are. Put them back the same way. Now there's also a bushing in there that can come out, so be careful with that. Now we're going to release the brake here. Just go ahead and unscrew that. That's all there is. You know, here is a good time to just clean this outside. Use a Q-tip to get in there. Make it look nice. Now we're going to go ahead and unscrew these. Oh, that one's in there pretty good. Okay, be careful taking this apart because under here there's going to be some brake or your drag washers, so we just want to make sure we don't lose anything. And also, like I said, be careful this bushing here, it might come out too. So that's what we have. Again, here I would suggest taking your rag, clean everything up. Get it nice and dry. You can pop that bushing out if you want. Run a Q-tip around in there. You know, dry off the bushing. And so you don't lose it, you know, just stick it back in there. And we'll go ahead and set this piece aside. Okay, now we're gonna get into this. When you take this off, it just slides off the post. Be careful because there is a tiny gold washer under there that might stick to the bottom and might come off with it. I take it off. See that? That one's the fixed one. This is the one that stayed on there. And that's the one that might come off. Go ahead and take it off. Just a small washer. Go ahead, just dry this piece off, get it clean. Okay. Now you're gonna take your oil. You're gonna put one drop of oil right at the base of that post. You're gonna go ahead, put that small washer back on there. And you're gonna put another drop right on top. Just gonna set that aside for now. Now here, there's a couple different pieces here. You got all your washers in there. You got your gear, and then the post. You take it apart, be careful because these washers can come off. Now there's metal washers and felt washers in here. So what I do is I set them down in the order that they come off. And it's always metal, felt, metal, felt. That's what you should have. What you want to do here is just dry everything off good. And you want to make sure this stuff is very dry. Otherwise, this can cause some slippage in your drag system. So make sure you have clean rags for this. Make sure your hands are pretty dry. And just put it back together in the order that you found it. So you got the post, you got the gear, you have a felt washer here. A metal washer with no ridges. Another felt washer. A metal washer with a couple of ridges that are going to fit into these slots here. Another felt washer. And the top. Okay, now what we're gonna do, we're gonna place a little bit of grease on these gears here. I like to put a little bit on the small one here. And I like to spread some around the edges of the big one. Okay. You can just slide that right back onto the post here. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and start putting this back together. Now to start with, these are going to be the pieces that we need. We got the spool, the plate, the gears, the brake knob, and a couple screws. Now we're going to go ahead and set this back onto here. Now there's only one way it can go because you've got your notch here for the release. And obviously this post goes through that hole. But before we do that, actually, I forgot. We need to drop some oil in there. And a little bit around there. Now we're good to put it on. If that bushing pops up, just put it back on, push it down. Okay, we'll go ahead and put those screws back in there. Go ahead and put your brake knob back on there. Go ahead and tighten it down all the way if you'd like. Okay, we're gonna place a drop of oil in here now. Now this can only go in one way, and that's the brass ring side first. You're going to put it in there, and it should make a little bit of a popping noise because there is a little clip on the inside of the brake knob that'll hold it into place. Okay? Now once that's in there, we're going to go ahead and drop couple drops of oil too around this. We want that to spin freely. All right. Now what I like to do actually is I like to put this part of the spool on first. You can kind of see there's some grooves around there that will line up with these metal pins inside the spool. I like to just try to get those lined up as best as I can anyway. You won't necessarily feel them fit in there or anything, so it is kind of tough. Just, you know, do the best you can. Now we're going to take the other half here. We're going to put them together. And then we're going to tighten down these thumb screws. I can go ahead and also loosen up the brake a little bit now. Well, it might be too late. Yep, I got it on there too tight. So what I'm gonna have to do is loosen these thumb screws. Just a little bit, and then I should be able to loosen up that brake. Loosen that up just a little bit and go back and tighten down the thumb screws. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and put the handle back on. Those should be the pieces that we have. We're going to start with those two washers. Again, make sure they're oriented in the right way. They should look like parentheses. Slide those on the post. And then your drag star there will just spin right on. Okay. Now again, this washer should go on face down, so it's kind of bent in the middle. We're going to put the nut back on. I'm sorry. Actually, the nut does not go on, the handle goes first. Duh. Put your handle on. And the nut. I thought something wasn't looking right. Wrench to tighten that down. Okay, now this little clip. Same thing putting it on. Be very careful. Put it on there. Use your finger as a backdrop and use your precision screwdriver to push it on. Go. And then the nut cap will go right on top. Sometimes it might be a little off, so you might just have to loosen or tighten that nut just a little bit to make it line up. There we go. There you go, guys. Put back together. Tighten the drag down a little bit. You can see the worm gear rolling. Tension knob works. You know, tighten it down. You can feel it. There you go. How to disassemble, clean, and put back together an Abu Garcia 6500 C3 reel. Thanks for watching. Oh, sorry guys, forgot to mention bait clicker on. Everything working. So there you guys go. That's how to take apart, clean, and reassemble an Abu Garcia 6500 C3 reel. Button works, you can hear it engage, see the worm gear moving, bait clicker, drag, brake. That's how it's done. Again, this will save you money in the long run, guys. Thanks for watching.